We are privileged to have with us the people who have made India proud in the recent Asian Games. Led by Pulela Gopichand, the Dronacharya of Indian badminton, we have with us H.S. Pranoy, the person who won a bronze medal for us in the singles after 41 years, and of course the smashing duo of badminton, Satvik Sairaj Ranki Reddy and Chirag Shetty. We'll ask them what exactly makes them what they are in this world, and of course we'll come and grill the guru also on what is it that he does that makes them so special. Come and start with you, Pranoy. By the time people start looking at taking it easy, you are having a year which is, you know, you are perhaps, there is nobody in the world who is happy playing you anymore because you have been beating almost anyone. What is it that explains this change in you at this phase of your career?
I think, sir, a lot of things have changed the last few years. I think the first thing is to probably train much more happier. I think that is the one thing which has changed over the years with a lot more less pressure on performance, and I think that has kind of changed a lot of things for me personally also. So now training has become a fun part, and I just want to get up in the morning and go to the training. So that change has come in the last 3 years, and the results have been shown, especially in the last 2 years.
So other than just training, is there any change you have made to your game or anything which has resulted in all this?
So I would say last 1.5 years, that's where I've started working again with Bhaiya. Again, we had a small gap in between, and again started working with Bhaiya last 2 years, and a lot of things started to fall in place post that, because we had a lot of discussion on how we can tune up my game and to focus on the physical side of it, and to plan how physically we can be fresh for tournaments and for training was the key. Changes in the last 2 years. So to understand how my body works and how a 31-year-old year can probably go out there and be the best in the world. I think we had a lot of discussion on that, and probably that kind of helped in the recent past.
I believe during the Asian Games also you had a severe backache, but you never showed it during the game. You were completely strapped, I could see, but tell us more about it.
I think as a badminton player, the good thing for me, I would say, was had a lot of injuries when I was young, from 22 to 27, and that kind of gave a lot of lessons, and all those lessons, I would say, have benefited me post 30 to understand and to realize that this is a part of the sport, and to take how much of positive things out of those phases. Especially, I think Asian Games was one big example where things were totally off on a lot of days for us. But to fight each and every day, and to have that happy face outside, to have that positive energy, and to have all the people around with Bhaiya also, to have that positive energy coming in with the team, I think that gave a big difference in the results. And I was not thinking about the pain when I was
playing. Not crediting your wife, 1.5 years of marriage and fantastic results all these years.
There's a major change in the last 2 years.
Yeah. I guess so. I think she has been getting a lot of credit from my family, of course, saying that there's a lot of good performance coming in right after the marriage. So yes, I think there is some big luck coming in from her side, touch wood. So hopefully it continues for many more years.
So he makes up after he was nushed to say that. Otherwise, he had not mentioned. I don't know, we let it pass. So Satvik, Chirag, congratulations once again for an absolutely amazing run of A that you guys have been having. Chirag, you were not well on the day of the semi-final too?
No, sir. Actually, after the first match, so we had a day off. Mm-hmm. And our teammate, Rohan Kapoor, he was the first one who fell ill. Mm-hmm. And when I saw him at the stadium, I sort of had a sensation in my throat as well. And I think that's when it started. And luckily for us, we had a day off after our first match. So when the peak of that infection started, I had a day off, so I could rest for a day at least to get back. Although I wasn't at my best, but I could still enter the court, and I think yeah, some things you can't really explain.
Correct.
Yeah.
But tell me, Satvik, when your partner is unwell and there is a bit of uncertainty over what is happening, what goes through your head at a time like that?
I'm not sure about what happened to him, because everyone was kind of sick and everyone was disappointed. And then I shifted to other room, because at least I should be able to play and get on court if I get chance. And I wasn't not thinking so much about him. I know once he get on court, he will play 100%. That for sure. I was being positive, like let me not get into pressure and think so much like what will happen. I was in my happy zone. I was doing my routine, same routine, and I was kind of little bit careful so that I won't be sick. So so I was aware of it. So yeah, luckily on the we got a break, as Chirag said, like that helped us. I mean, to recover.
Okay.
Yeah.
Tell us the secret of your combination. How do you guys gel the way you do on the court? You know, one can see absolutely the most powerful smashes in the world from the both of you. I also see a lot of coordination. Kai bari sunai deta mar mar, you know,
har bar
mar
every point
mar. So you know, in fact, I have heard the commentators, they probably, some of them don't understand what it means, so they are trying to do their own interpretation of what exactly you are saying. But you know, we Indians are having a good laugh, and of course we see the results and we feel very excited. What is the secret that, you know, you guys, when did this almost instinctive understanding of each other's game happen? How did it happen?
Sir, I think it's the bond that we share off court. I think both of us are extremely good friends off court, and I feel for an on court partnership to blossom, you need to be really good friends off court. I have that thing where like both of us, it's sort of, we are in a marriage. And there will be things that you like and dislike, but you need to be adjusting and know that the other person wants the best for you as well. And yeah, I think both of us are really good friends off court, and that bond is what gets us going on court.
That reminds me, there are days when either, you know, you or you are not having a good day on the court. Do you get upset? कि तूने पूरा गेम खराब कर दिया आज, क्या तू ऐसा कर रहा था नेट के ऊपर?
या आई थिंक इवन इन दिस टूर्नामेंट आई वुड से लाइक प्रॉब्ली इन द सेमीफाइनल्स सात्विक मे नॉट हैव स्टार्टेड द बेस्ट, एंड इन द फाइनल्स आई डिड नॉट स्टार्ट ऑफ इन द बेस्ट वे पॉसिबल, बट इन द सेमीफाइनल्स आई बैक्ड हिम अप, एंड इन द फाइनल्स ही बैक्ड मी अप. सो आई थिंक दैट्स व्हाट अ पार्टनरशिप इज, यू बैक ईच अदर अप व्हेन द अदर पर्सन इज लो, एंड आई थिंक व्हेन यू बैक ईच अदर अप, you know, I know for a fact that if I am not playing well, he is there to back me, and so is the case with him. So yeah, that's
are
that's
there times when you don't talk to each other, you're so upset with each other?
No, not at all.
Okay, coming to you again, what is the role that a coach really plays in shaping your game and everything when something is not going right repeatedly? What is it that you come to the coach for, and how do you work on that then?
I would say, I think it's a trust. Trust thing, saying, I think there's a lot of times where you don't believe in yourself, where things doesn't go well, when there's a season which doesn't go right, you start to think that what all you're doing is not right. But that's where I think coaches come in place big time, where they keep telling you that what you're doing is right, and you have to just keep doing it. And I think for me, being with Bhaiya for last 15 years, we had a lot of ups and downs in this 15 years of badminton. And I think a lot of times there were moments where, I remember 2018 Cornwall Games was one such event for me, where I came back without a medal. And I remember the next week I went out there in Asian Badminton Championship and won the bronze, which was much more tougher competition out there. So, but I remember in 2018 that Commonwealth Games, we had a discussion, and Bhaiya said, these kind of days are going to come, but it's how much you are going to work harder from here for the next big tournament. And we just had, I think I remember we hardly had 6 days to again go back and do the job. And so these kind of learnings, I think I had in my 15 years of career, and that's where he came in very, very strong messages for us, because I think we always think from one perspective as a player, and they think from a very different perspective, and that gives us a lot of different rooms to work on. And so I think that's where a whole thing of coach come into place.
Interesting. Same question to the two of you. The role that the coach really plays, you know, in your game, you know, you started with, you know, obviously him, you know, and then you have had a series of specialist coaches and all. Tell me how does it change? What is it that makes a difference, and how it all shows up in the game ultimately?
I think as Pranayana said, like it starts with trust. I think you should have trust on coach, like what you're doing. Especially we have been with Bo from past 1.5 years. Mm. So initially, especially me, I wasn't really comfortable because he was kind of European style. We are playing kind of Asian style. He came and he changed few things and I was not really comfortable. He changed my positions. He told me to play front court, which is not really comfortable. He told me to bend always, which is not easy for me. So there was a lot of struggle for me. Initially, I was struggling for that. Then later on, I realized like he was there to help you. It's not like he is there to damage you. So that mindset changed me. Then I started trusting him. Then slowly things fall in place. Then we got a good results. Then obviously Gopi sir was there all the time for me from the young age till now. He was there, and I call him magician all the time, mantrik.
A lot of Indians call him that.
I believe that all the time. Mm. So whenever he started traveling with us recently from Indonesia Open, for the first time,
yeah.
I felt like I am playing new tournament. Mm. I felt so much positive when I look back. There's something peaceful there around the corner sitting. So there's no worry. If we lose also, there's no worry. So we played our heart out in the Indonesia Open. We gave our best. We won our first Super 1000 title. Then followed by Korea Open, we played really well. Then again, a few things here and there. Then again, Asian Games, we are there. Which things are not going really well from the past few tournaments. Then again, everything fell place in the right time.
Fantastic. How about you for the same question?
So yeah, I think I totally agree with what Satvik said. It's all about trust. As players, you really need to trust your coach. I think that it's first, and I think if once you do that, then everything falls into place. So I think it's extremely important. Trust is really, really important.
How do you generate this kind of a trust among all the people who play, you know, who train under you? Is that because you were a player yourself, or what is the reason that, you know, it may be asking you to praise yourself, but how does it happen?
I think to just put things in perspective, I just feel one, when I'm sitting there, I just feel so privileged to be there. Just to be there to watch that from such close quarters and see these boys perform at that level. When I'm looking at, say, a Pranoy going through the pain of match after match, sticking to discipline, which is not his core thing, in the sense he's playing a game which is not his natural game, but he is trusting you and he is going out there and he's saying, I'll play this game. And then when it works, it just gives you that kind of immense satisfaction. And also what Satvik and Chirag have achieved, and to be, although they give credit for that, I think the reality is that so Matthias has been, of course, there, hugely supportive. There's other coaches, this Guru has worked really hard. There is the strength and conditioning team, which is there. He works with Invictus, they work with Caleb, and there's Kiran, who was really, and Sumanju, really put their heart out to bring these people back. So I think totally, on the ground,
teamwork.
It's such a big amount of teamwork, such an amount of positivity, because at the end of the day, sometimes you don't really know what's happening, but then you trust your instincts, you pray to God and you say, boss, ye kaam karega. And then you just hope that these things, and in my life, luckily, whenever I've taken these big gambles about telling these things, it just worked, and somehow that gives you the confidence to say these things. But at the end of the day, it's how much of love, respect and trust which the players put on you. And you want to reciprocate that and ensure that you deliver. And for me, that's how these things are.
out of these three, who is the most difficult to train?
Well, that's, I think these three, honestly, you're looking at some of the finest people you can ever have in terms of discipline, in terms of humility, in terms of the genuine quality of people they are. Mm. And I think truly India could not have, or badminton could not have, more worthy champions than these three fellows. Oh, nice. Who are standing.
If I say who is the dream trainee out of all these, you won't name them either?
I think each of them is, I would say. I think to have somebody who has the ability, and I'm saying, seeing this from close quarters, and I'm seeing the way they've played the finals, and I'm seeing, was what I'm seeing from outside the court, Sattvic is able to see it on court at that pace. When the guy is rushing, he's seeing him rushing. When he's standing, he's seeing him standing. When he's squatting, he's going over their heads. I think he's just able to do that instinctively, and that's God's grace, really, to have that ability. Chirag is actually there putting pressure, and he's like all over the place with that amazing speed. Mm. And he just give him one small tip about managing something, and then he just maximizes that tip mm. to the maximum. And then Pranoy, I think I only know how much I'm sitting there and I'm wondering why this fellow has to go through so much of pain in each match mm. to kind of win. And it kind of takes a lot of discipline to do that, in the sense, back in, day out, match after match. And I think I'm just feel so lucky and privileged to be part of this whole journey.
You know, both of you are evoking fear in the mind of your opponents. Who are the people who you think are the ones who you are slightly, you know, wary of facing? Because you think because most of the people I have spoken to, they say we are scared of them because of the power and the combination that they have, you know. You evoke fear in them. Who are the people who do a similar kind of a thing for you?
I would say everyone. But I feel about the situation. It's not about the opponents. So it depends on situation. If I'm in a really comfortable place, I don't feel fear. I feel very happy. And these days, literally, we started very less thinking about the opponents. We started focusing on ourselves. If you want to be happy on court, you can see all the time we will have some kind of fun, Josh all the time smiling. We don't mind losing also, but we wanted to give her 100% from our side. Then see opponents what gameplay they will play, and they want to change the strategy and come. So our game plan, I think everyone will know. Our game plan is 90% attack. That everyone will know. But we don't mind playing that throughout the tournament, throughout the year, throughout our career. We'll stick to that plan till the other come with a different plan, and we just want to enjoy there. No matter what, we don't think so much about the opponents and all.
How about you?
I used to have, like, we both used to have a very tough time playing against Aaron and So, the ones who we beat in the semi-finals. Until 2 months back, we were 8-0 down against them. We had never beaten them before, and it was more of a psychological battle than a physical battle on court. But I think that Indonesia Open final changed it for us. And the last time we played them, like 4 days back, we beat them on 17 and 12, which probably 2-3 months back we wouldn't have thought we could.
Nice.
Yeah.
So these two are the two people who you think you have maximum respect for. Otherwise,
As in, we had way too much respect, I feel. Mm-hmm. thought, like, we used to give them more respect than we should on court. Not that they are really good players, obviously, but we used to think they have way more skills than we do. But we actually also did the skills, but we just didn't use it against them.
A mental block, as you said.
Exactly.
Which went after you beat them, yeah, at the Indian Open.
And but now, lately, there's no. We are much more free when we play against them, and there's no sort of mental block. We are not scared of their spin service or anything. We just go out there and have fun.
Is there anybody among the non-badminton playing guys who you have a lot of respect for? Among sportsperson, if I were to ask you to name someone.
Idols?
Yeah. Non-badminton also.
I have two sporting idols, I think. Usain Bolt and Rafael Nadal.
How about you?
Some opposite to him. I am fan of Roger Federer. The cool, the calm, the mind. and I inspire Pranay Anna, the king, the mind, the fighter. So yeah, he's my inspiration.
So same question to you. Who are the people who you find it's a challenge to play with them and it actually inspires you to do even better among in the badminton field itself?
Also everyone, sir. I think I think if you ask me somebody from the juniors circuit also, I think it's tough. Because I think badminton is such a competitive sport out there, and especially in the men's single side, when you look at the performance in the recent past, there have been very less multiple winners out there. It's all a lot of fresh new faces and a lot of youngsters coming out there. So it's very hard to be consistently playing at the top level. So I would say I think I give respect to each one of them, because everybody is good in what they're doing right now.
And your non-badminton sports idol?
I'd say Messi.
Messi, okay. I was in Kerala and I remember during the World Cup, so there was a competition between Messi and Ronaldo. That place seemed to have more Messi and Ronaldo, you know, followers than probably anywhere else, you know. And if I were to ask you, you see sports so much and you see some people do strange things and you say, if this guy was playing badminton, he would have been a champion. Do you have any such people in mind?
I don't know, sir, but I think, say, as I said, somebody like a Messi, I would always imagine how much happiness he gives when you watch football, right? I mean, it just, I feel I'm so attracted to somebody in sport just because the way they conduct on the field. And when a ball comes to him, you just feel like something magic is going to happen each and every time. I think that kind of happens to probably Federer and Messi is what I always have, what I've always seen, that whenever a ball comes in, you always feel that your heart is saying that something they're going
magic.
To do something,
some magic. Some magic
yeah,
will
some
happen.
Magic, but
you guys don't remember having seen Maradona, no?
I have not seen Maradona,
okay.
So.
Okay. I'm from that era, so, you know, I disagree with that. I think Maradona was better. What are the challenges that you have been facing? You know, you were a member of the Olympic Task Force. We were together and we gave a lot of recommendations. You see some of the things which have been implemented. Where are the real challenges that you think lie ahead for us to continue to have, you know, this caliber and quality and results on a sustained basis?
Well, I think these are happy moments for us. We've won the medal, so I don't want to go into what can be done or what is negative about it. But one thing is sure, I'm not the one who's going to shy away from saying what needs to be said. There are a lot of lacunes in the sporting ecosystem which need to be addressed. I think we are far from an ideal scenario. Many of them don't even understand the very concepts of what should be done. And I hope that we're going to change. I'm saying this with the reason that the Prime Minister, who's taken a personal interest in the task force to be formed in sport to get to this place in the last 10 years, I think we should be doing better. And I hope that a lot of sports have done quite a bit, and the improvement at the Asian Games is phenomenal. But as far as badminton is concerned, I would really love to see more opportunities given to youngsters, more structure being in the training programs, and a lot more which can be done to ensure that this crop of players continue to have more and more players behind them who will actually fill up the ranks in the future.
What is your inspiration? You know, you have been coaching for such a long time.
I think I'm looking at a Pranoy, Satvik and a Chirag talking here, and in my mind, I have not followed many other sports. Then when I look at their sport and what these guys can do magic with, I just feel that what they have done is phenomenal from a discipline perspective. I don't know, I haven't seen Nadal from close quarters, but I think what Pranoy has done is nothing less than him. What magic Satvik and Chirag have got and done here, in that speed, at that time, in those matches, with that kind of a pressure. I think for me, what we are looking at is not any less than what a Messi or a Ronaldo is. And yeah, I might be biased towards my children. I also might be biased towards the sport. But this is genuinely and truly what I feel.
Is there any personal hobby that you incorporated into your training schedule for everybody, which you thought will help everybody, because you followed it very closely?
Well, I just want them to be happy. I just want them to work from a space of happiness. And I believe that success follows. And this is what you don't have to really go out there and party to show that you're happy. But then internally, I think that sense should remain, and that consistency in training should remain. And that is what will give you enough results for the future.
Thank you very much for spending the time with us. It's been a pleasure to have you over.
Thank you.
Thank you so much. Pleasure to have you.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir.